Cub fans, but I got to put that in there. But really, what a tremendous week of baseball, football, hockey starting up. We've got a lot of things to show you. My special guests today are going to be Matt Dillon, the fine coach at Dowling High School, Kirk Daddow, the outstanding older coach, we call it, referred to him as, I think this is about his 20th year in Ames, and certainly Merritt Norville, the fine athletic director at Michigan State University. So those are our special guests, our guests, and Chuck, you tell us about the action.
Yeah, we've got fine guests and fine games this week to show. We're going to show five games this week. We're going to show the big win for Iowa and the comeback against Michigan State. We're going to show Ohio State taking control of the Big Ten race with a big win over Penn State. We're going to show Nebraska, who really seem to have found themselves a win yesterday against Kansas State. And then two high school games, the Iowa City High, Iowa City West game over in Iowa City for the boot, and the Ames-Dowling game between numbers 3 and 4, with the Iowa City game being 1 and 2. So a lot of good high school football this weekend, as well as some good college football. And we're going to start it off right now in Iowa City, where you didn't tell me you went to the game. How come you didn't offer me to go with you?
I still have to go incognito, cause so I got that hat right after I got there.
Yeah, it looks like you needed it on a sunny day in Iowa City. But Hawks off to a slow start, trail at 17-0 when Matt Sherman finds a wide-open Chris Knipper. He takes it in 35 yards for the touchdown, 17-7 at that point. Now, I thought that was a big play to get the Hawks back in the game. They trailed 23-10 at half. Then in the second half, Matt Sherman finding Cedric Shaw. He'll stroll into the end zone, a 5-yard touchdown pass, and that tied the game up at 23. Later in the third quarter, Michigan State's fine freshman running back Cedric Irvin takes it in from the 3, 30-23 Michigan State. They regain control, but it was short-lived. C. Hollins, 9 yards up the middle. City High, J.D. Hill, the former NFL player, wide open. He caught 3 touchdown passes on the day. City High led it 14-7 at that point. They win it 28-7. They'll be number one when the polls come out this week.
No question about it, and Larry Brown got his revenge. He got beaten. He was beaten twice last year by West High.
Right.
So, and they will have to play again, Chuck. There's
it
no
looks
question
that way
about
in
it.
The
These
playoffs.
Two teams will be playing somewhere down the line before this thing settles this fall.
Right, and a great game, and it will be a great game again. That's the third time they've played in about, I think, 10 games.
Probably getting tired of each other.
They're very familiar with each other. Two teams also familiar with each other, number 3 Ames and number 4 Dowling. Homecoming at Ames, a huge crowd of over 10,000 people at the game, and they saw a great one. Here, Dowling's Joe Estee takes the pitch, goes 9 yards around right in, 14-7 Maroons at this point in the second quarter. Ames would come back and tie it, then on the last play of the half, Dowling kicker Josh Snowberger pounds a 37-yard field goal. I had plenty of length on that one. The Maroons led it 17-14 at the break. But the second half saw Ames' ground game get going. Aaron Grieving, just a sophomore, will break a tackle, and he'll take it 55 yards. He had 148 yards on the night. Just put the little Cyclones up 21-17. Now, moments later, fullback A.J. Wilson will take it in 10 yards for the little Cyclones. Just made it 28-17 at that point. They would hang on to win it 35-31. They stopped Dowling in the final minute inside the 20. And the little Cyclones, they'll be number 2 when the polls come out this week.
No question about it. It's a fantastic football game, people. There was 10,000 people there. It was an unbelievable electricity.
That's the word you're looking for.
It was just magnificent ball game. I got so excited watching how well it was coached, how well it was played. A.J. Wilson's a former, the son of one of my former coaches, Jamie Burrows. So it's kind of very personal to me, and that's why maybe people wonder why I keep going to Ames games, because I have a real attachment to that. But magnificent game, and these two teams will probably have to do it again too, Chuck.
Well, they've met. That's the second time for them, and I think 6 or 7 games.
Right.
So the best teams from last year, still the best teams this year. But great high school football this last weekend in the state of Iowa. The coaches in that Ames-Dowling game, Kirk Daddow from Ames and Matt Dillon from Dowling, they're going to be our interview guests coming up after this break, and it's going to be interesting to see how their game plans worked out, because the interviews were done before the game.
Right.
Stay tuned for that right after these messages.
A game like this,
background, you came here from Florida, so a lot of people think that's where you got your roots and what you've done, but you've been through Iowa before.
Oh, yes, sir, absolutely. I've got my undergraduate degree from Cornell College. That's where I played my college football, and my master's degree is from Iowa State. Of course, you're familiar with that a little bit. So, so I've spent a lot of time here in the state of Iowa. I've also been out in Montana and Florida, so I've kind of seen the country a little bit, but we like to call this home, and my wife and I are excited to be back here.
Is your wife from the state of Iowa?
Yes,
did you meet her at Cornell?
I met her at Cornell, and she's a Des Moines Roosevelt graduate.
Oh, okay.
So
Well, she's pretty happy. Aren't they doing pretty well? All right. Yeah, I know one of them's 4-5-0.
Yeah, I guess they sure are. But she'll know what side of the stadium to sit on when we play. So,
all right. Well, Matt, let me ask you this question. We're talking, it's a big showdown. This interview will certainly be after the game is played. But what do you think going in, as we look back, what do you think you've got to do to beat Ames High? You got the three of four best teams in the nation, I mean, in the state 4A, going head-to-head.
Well, I'll tell you, I think the things that Ames does so well offensively is their balance. They've got a real nice passing game with Steve Rimmer, who throws the ball extremely well, and Burrow's a great receiver as a tight end, and Charter's got excellent speed outside, and they spread you all over the field, and then they run grieving at you as a running back, and he reminds me a lot of a young Troy Davis coming up there out of Ames, and you know, he's just an outstanding player, and he's only a sophomore, so they do a lot of things awfully well offensively, and then defensively they just line up and come after you, and you've got to be good enough to block them, and those are the things that they present problems.
Okay, What are you doing offensively? What are you, a double wing, single wing, one back? What is your keynote? What are you going to try to attack them with?
Well, you know, we're looking at a lot of different formations, but our big thing right now, I think, is we've got to establish our running game with Joe Essie and Brian Ollie and Jeremy Nixon and Willie Lawson. Those four guys have got to have a great ball game for us, and when we have the opportunity to throw the football, we need to be successful. So far, our QBs are completing about a 57 or 58% clip, so that's not too bad, and we're averaging about 10 yards an attempt. So when you look at our passing game, I'd say we've been very efficient. Our quarterback, Ben Remont, you know, you look at the NCAA pass efficiency ratings, he's higher than anybody in the NCAA right now. His efficiency rating's at a 199 right now, and I think the highest in the NCAA is like a 186. So he has really thrown the ball well. We've thrown for 8 touchdowns and only 1 interception in 4 ball games. So we feel real good about where our passing game is right now, and we've got to take advantage of those opportunities as they present themselves in the game.
Okay, a replay. Last year, Don Morrow is not here. You've come into the beautiful program, traditionally great team, Dowling High School's tradition goes 100 years. This team played, they went head-to-head last year, had a tremendous comeback in the semifinals, wasn't it, Chuck?
Yes, sir.
Do you feel that's a help? Will that be a carryover thing? A rally cry, so to speak?
I think it'll be a help for Ames. I know they've been looking forward to this since last November, so. You know, I know they're gearing for this game, and our kids are hopefully will rise to the challenge. You know, I see a lot of different things coming out of this. I think it's their homecoming, and I know they've got all these things, all these emotions going into the ball game, and hopefully that those emotions will play against them a little bit. I know our focus is it's an important football game. Just like any other game, it's a step on the ladder to get us to where we want to be at the end of the season in November. We're not so concerned with it's Ames High, it's 3-4. We've just got to take care of business, and hopefully we'll go play well, and I know this, we'll play hard.
Matt Dillon, good luck. I know you're going to play hard. It's glad to have nice to have you back in the state, and good luck Friday.
Thank you, Coach. I appreciate it.
Well, you heard what Coach Dillon had to say. Now let's go directly hear what Coach Daddow has to say.
The second half of our 3-4 duo is Kirk Daddow, and we're just extremely happy to have the Ames High School football coach. This program will be airing after the game is over, so I'll ask you the same thing I asked Coach Dillon. Mm-hmm. What have you got to do, Coach Daddow, to beat Dowling?
Well, you know, actually, we have to put together 48 minutes of football because that's something we haven't done yet this year, and we've played extremely well at times, and we've proved that we can be just about as bad as anybody in the state too. So I think if we put 4 quarters together, I think it can be a close, exciting game.
Strength of your team. What do you feel like right now, offensive, defensively? What are you standing on? How are you getting? How have you won these ball games?
Well, I'm an old defensive coach. I came up through the ranks as a defensive coach, and I think you have to start with that side of the ball. I think we've been real sound defensively. I have a great defensive staff. And so, I mean, we want to get out there and try to control the ball defensively, and then we've relied on a good balance run and pass this year, and fortunately we've been able to have that. We've had a good running game, and I think we have a real effective passing attack at times.
Okay. Last time you played Dowling, it was one of the most exciting games for a person who didn't have anything to lose. For you, it was a reach into your heart and pull it out type game because you had a tremendous lead. You were in control.
last-minute heroics denied the game. Is that going to be a factor? Has too many guys moved on? Where's the last year's Ames-Dowling game in your mind as far as this year's team?
Well, you know, it really isn't very much in our minds. I don't hear the kids talking about it. You know, high school guys have awful short memories. And even though some of our best players were out on that field, I mean, this is this year, that was then. And right now we're looking to play Dowling because they're one of the best teams in the state. And if we can beat them, that would be a great thing for us.
Kurt, you've been in coaching, I think. Well, I'll let you tell us. What years, how many years you've been, where have you been, and what's going on in your life of coaching?
Well, I've been 29 years coaching high school football in the state of Iowa, and 18 years, past 18 years in Ames. And, you know, I stay in coaching because, you know, I have the possibility of coaching in games like the one Friday. I don't like games that are out of hand. I wouldn't switch jobs with Tom Osborne right now. I don't know how he stands it out there on the sidelines in front of, you know, with all of those routes. But a game like this where you can match your staff and your players against the very best staff and players, that's a great thrill for me, and I'm really looking forward to Friday.
Last question, put you on the spot. Word is this team ranked pretty good with some of the teams you've had? If some of you've had some, and I want to say this, I want to thank you personally for all the athletes you provided us at Iowa State. I think we had six of your players, and I've always said if all our guys that would have played and performed as hard as the athletes you provided us while I was at Iowa State, it would have been a little bit different story in some areas. But where's this team rank in your mind, if you can?
Well, you know, I really think it can be as good as anybody we've had at Ames, any team we've had in the last 18 years. We've got some size that we normally don't have. We have some speed that we usually do have. And we've got good experience at crucial positions. So this could probably be the best team that we've had at Ames, but it isn't there yet.
Well, before I close, I'll tell you one thing. Is this Jimmy Burrow you got coaching for you the same Jimmy Burrow that coaches for the Barnstormers? Everybody I interview's got Jimmy Burrow working for him.
I tell you, you know, Jim has come on and he's been a tremendous addition to our staff. And to have somebody who's been where he's been and can give us that kind of input on both sides of the ball has been really great.
Well, for all of us, we want to thank you for being on our show. Mm-hmm. And even though the game will be over before you see it, good luck Friday.
Thanks a lot, Jim.
You bet.
Two good coaches with a pretty good handle on that game before they played it going in.
You bet.
Very good interview. Coming up, another good interview with Merritt Norvell.